people. And so let's pick up from where we left off and give you an opportunity to talk about it at where you wish to start.
Sure. Now I can pick up in the area of the Deep South. And in the Deep South, as I had said about Booker T. Washington and the late Dr. Horace Harvey, who said, the old spirituals, this is very important, the old spirituals were born in the hearts of our ancestors in the fields. And in the Caribbean, they even referenced to the fact that they knew when they got out of slavery that they didn't have health care or anything like that, but their medicine was in the music. And that's the same thing here in America. And in the area which I came up in, we were taught to always stay near the church where the old songs are sang, mm-hmm. because they are our anchor and they're the means by which our ancestry passed mm-hmm. from one generation to the next. Mm-hmm. And the church was like our musical hospital. Mm-hmm. The first civil rights movement actually took place in Mississippi mm-hmm. in a music studio. Mm-hmm. It wasn't the one that people think it mm-hmm. actually was. Mm-hmm. And I recall when they rewrote the songs in the 60s and went into the streets and sang them. When they come back, Dr. Haney, they were not the same singers they left as. These are key points, and it's very important in order for us to bring the music back that will help heal the country. And one of the professors at Emory University has said, after studying all the families around the world, mm-hmm. he concluded that the healing of the American family will start with the point of the old spirituals. Mm-hmm. And the maestro here, I heard him say in a chemistry class at Vanderbilt University that there's a composer who wrote that one day mm-hmm. music will play a great role in saving the world. Mm-hmm. I believe that we are in that day today. Mm-hmm. And I've kept my music pure. I'm probably the purest person in America when it comes to music. And this past Sunday, I actually decided to only go to Sunday school because I don't want to see, for me to make my music pure, to mix it up, that's lose money, you know. And so
when you say that you've kept your music pure,
yes.
it means that you don't mix music that you use in Sunday school,
church,
with church worship. Music or worship music.
Right. No. I don't mix it. And one of the other things that have taken place here, the old songs which are born in the hearts of our ancestors in the fields, mm-hmm. that was when the European American owned the field. Mm-hmm. And now I've connected the old songs to a fourth generation farm. Mm-hmm. You know, in reference to the fact of mentioning to you that we discovered that have inherited a farm mm-hmm. in Alabama. Mm-hmm. So what you have here, that's the heart of the America. The country is the farm and the music.
Yes, that's the land and the music.
Born out of the land. Yes. Mm-hmm. And one of the other things we have got to go back and do, we have got to look at the side effects of the music from the 60s. Mm-hmm. And see, like a lot of African Americans have OD'd on the MLK dream and this freedom song, mm-hmm. suffering from mental indigestion mm-hmm. of the 60s. Mm-hmm. You can't sing nothing but freedom songs and protest music, mm-hmm. you know. And these are things we have got to discuss. And you know, Dr. Haney, I believe today we have got to do more discussing music rather than singing music.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think that's what we're trying to do here now, mm-hmm. Minister. That is to talk about the music that you know and the music that we've used for all kinds of purposes. I think you've indicated that music was used in the civil rights movement.
Yes.
It was a way that we protested.
Yes.
But we also know that music was also an element of entertainment.
Yes,
when
that's right.
We talk about slavery and musicals, the African musical tradition during that period, how did Africans express themselves in music on plantations?
Well, one of the excellent examples of that is about 2005, Oprah Winfrey had a gala, and she had all of those singers to come together, Maria Shriver, one of the ABC News persons, and they were all singing what I call the modern entertainment type hymns and spirituals. And you had the young singers there, and they were just amazed because they had never seen this aspect of our heritage people. Everybody was amazed. But one of the key things, and I think Sidney Poitier said this, that it was so spontaneous. You know, you can't control it. And in the spontaneity of the music is what makes it what it is. Mm-hmm. And what I remember was the singer named, I believe, Alicia Keys. Mm-hmm. She actually caught the spirit of the music. Mm-hmm. She said, this is something that we have got to keep going. Mm-hmm. And see, I understand that, Dr. Haney, and that means that the music is not taught, mm-hmm. it is caught. Mm-hmm. And by me keeping mine pure, mm-hmm. I'm able to go back and connect the music. And the only thing that I can show you what I mean here is when money, mm-hmm. when writing was added to money, mm-hmm. it never separated, mm-hmm. you know.
What do you mean when people started to write songs for money?
No. This is way back there. Uh-huh. When money was first, writing was first added to money, uh-huh. it never separated, mm-hmm. you know. And so I keep in my music pure, mm-hmm. because I know there's medicine in it. It is needed today to help heal. And Dr. Bradley's music was used in mm-hmm. the 60s to diffuse racial tension, mm-hmm. you know, across the country. Mm-hmm. And then mentioned about President Reagan's funeral music. Mm-hmm. All of those hymns in President Reagan's funeral music, I grew up on them, mm-hmm. every one of them, you know.
As a matter of fact, when you talk about Dr. Bradley, I think you're speaking of one of the great pioneers.
Yes.
In reference to African-American music, spiritual
yes.
music, and et cetera.
Yes.
So what we would like for you to do, Minister Taylor, when we come back, is for you to devote some time in
okay.
terms of this great pioneer. Because
yes.
I think that most of the music that we hear today, spiritual music and et cetera,
yes, yes.
will come primarily out of some of the things that Dr. Bradley did. And from not, and the most important thing, I think he was lived in Nashville, Tennessee. Is
that's
that right?
Right. Yes, and born in Memphis.
Okay, so we've got about a minute,
okay.
and then we want you to start talking about some information in reference to that experience.
Yes.
And then when we take our second commercial break. But
yes.
I think that some of the information that you're giving now is excellent, and I think it's the kind of information that we want to use, but we want to wrap it around an individual
yes.
That you believe. I know, because we've had conversations in reference to Dr. Bradley before. As a matter
yes.
of fact, I think you gave me
a book
yes. dealing with Dr.
That's
Bradley,
right.
and so I know that you've got a lot of information in reference to it. And so when we come back, then